Online. Yeah. Sure, there's no Discord. Yep. I know it's not gonna. Oh yeah, yeah. Yeah, everybody on party chat, I think, is here. Can be heard. It's supposed to be whoever's on the party is supposed to be visible or able to be heard. Judgment is same. Same as it did. Yeah, vodka. There's a sweater right here. Just pressing the touchpad. There's a jam in it. Touchpad. Dead, same as it was for me. Touchpad, it's showing me everything that was in it. So when I touch R3, oh, with the new fucking update shit. Yeah, sometimes it does it to me on that new update, yeah. Like this. This is what you're talking about. The dry bag backpack. Yeah, so now if I just, yep, no, I can't. So now if I just back out and go back into it, it shows me the whole thing. So I just touched the touchpad, went back to the touchpad. Yeah, I just hit circle and then touchpad and it showed me the whole of the bag. Thank you. to this shit right here is why we fucking move the cars. Some bullshit. From now to eternity, I give you all my heart. We are meant to be, it's clear to see. My love is bigger than I thought. I got everything I want when I hold you with my arms. Forever so mad that my love and my pleasure, the key to my treasure. Whatever's the weather, day up and now with you till I die. How many times for you, I'ma try. Want you to notice the one and I know this perfect soulmate. I wanna show my best friend. She gave me my life, my happy end in hard times. This is non-copyright music. Yeah. That's why it's not really typical music I listen to. Thank you. On top of the bridge. But I'm stepping in water. That's how you know there's some problems with the coding. Wow. It's all let's have some access to the imei.c file, man. Play with that and make it a little bit more right. Sometimes I get these lag spikes, bro, that feels like maybe somebody's joining. Or... never mind. It just runs fine, then all of a sudden. Glitch, rubber band. Yeah, but it's like they said, they haven't fixed the coding problems with Dayz. They might fix like a glitch here and there, but. Still gonna have lag now because the way the game is coded and played. It'd be funny if there's a little residual of our coding up here. Petrovka. So I was just saying it'd be funny if our residual coding was still here. Have a little furry friend jump out at me. I do kind of wonder though. Because jumping over to another server even one time in the same building, I might have seen a weapon rack. It's not posting it. Let's see why people use 3-dial lock. There's plenty. But there's plenty of 4-dial locks when people should be using 4-dial locks, they're using 3-dial locks. I don't know who doesn't loot a hunting store, you know? It's probably one of the best places to loot. the little hunting store and then the just the other regular stores, you know. You gotta be looting those things. That's where all the good stuff is sometimes. You get a tundra, you know. Blaze, no matter what server you're on. Unless you know, obviously, they don't spawn shit there, but most servers, like the hunting store, stuff like that. Our server, obviously, we got gift boxes and shit. Mm-hmm. Yeah, I don't know what is going on with that. For sure, yeah, for sure. Maybe if it'll work for somebody, it's not us. Thank you. See what I did? Can't get him as close as he used to be able to, but good enough. Good enough. They waited for you. How long do we have the night now? How do you really like it's nighttime? After the pitch black night, I'm like, shoot, this ain't nothing. I can see where I'm going. That pitch black, I was like, can't see nothing, man. Yeah, I guess my mom left her boyfriend, bro. I don't know if you heard that shit. So, he was a bitch. I kinda put that together, right? I went up there where they live on a horse ranch to help them out, show them how to run equipment and stuff, like tractors and whatnot. Because I grew up around all that stuff, and I worked on a farm, like a tree planting farm, where they have all this different kind of equipment for everything. And I worked it just where I lived, agricultural area, you know, and I worked on the equipment too, like as a mechanic. I pretty much know, I'm a, like a jack of all trades, you know, type of guy. But this one dude that she was up there, she wasn't with him, but they were real close or whatever. He hired me. He had a big old ranch. His dad actually owned a huge ranch that had miles and miles of pea and lentil fields. It almost looked like the ocean, but it's just like fields of lentil beans and peas, like the vegetables, you know. And he has tractors and all this stuff. Well, he hired me as a mechanic to work on all his equipment. And then when I left, you know, not very long ago, I guess, since it's been a few years ago since I've been there, but just like a couple months ago, my mom hired that guy that hired me to be a mechanic for him because he didn't know how to do it. He told her that he can work on her vehicle, and I guess he screwed her over. But I was like, Mom, I wish you, if you would have talked to me, then, you know, I would have told you that guy doesn't know what he's doing. It's like shit. And the problem was, like, I owned a mechanic shop for a while. And I'm not a certified mechanic, you know, so I didn't go to school or whatever to have a piece of paper that says I'm a mechanic, you know. But I have all these mechanic friends that went through schooling. They always come to me to ask me questions about how to do certain shit. And I'm like, well, didn't you go to school? You're a certified mechanic and you don't know how to do this shit? You're asking me, a non-certified mechanic. You know? It's just funny to me that they know what the book says, they don't know how to apply it in real life. So I'm like, this is what it's coming down to. And I'm not a book smart guy, by no means, you know. I'm a more hands on, like, I'll show you how to do it. I'm not gonna try to explain it to you because y'all fucked it up. It'll be all fucked up. But I can personally show you, and I don't know exactly how to, you know, some of the stuff now, you know, you don't know what's on a car anymore. Well, I don't anyways. I know how to work on it. I know how to dial it down to what the problem is, but I can't tell you exactly what that little sensor is called or something, you know. But I can reach down in there, grab a hold of that exact sensor, pull it out, put it back, put another one in or whatever, and know exactly what the problem was. I just can't say that's the mass airflow. I know what the mass airflow sensor is, shit like that, but there's other sensors on a car that they don't need to be there, but you know, they're there. Like the smog control systems on cars, they don't really do anything. They don't actually even help the environment. Actually, in time, they make it even worse, because they start putting out even more toxic fumes. Because it's just building up all that toxic fumes inside, and then has to go somewhere eventually. Looks like I'm gonna log out up here on the whatever this hill is called. I forget. Dochino, something like that. Chopper crashing. Haven't heard any. Strange for this area. Usually you at least hear them like out Vibor away. Something. Yeah, not a single one anyway. Alright, I'm gonna log, or not log out completely, but I'm gonna stop my broadcast right here.